And welcome back to the fourth episode of Inside American Independent Cinema. Boy oh boy, how I missed you all! Today, we are going to discuss James Mangold's movie released in 1995 called Heavy. So let's discover together which is the cinematic experience behind this very spectacular and profound movie. Heavy is Mangold's feature debut film. He received the jury recognition and won the special prize for directing at Sundance Film Festival back in 1995. The movie centers upon a story that tries to put together the pieces of a broken man's soul, tortured by loneliness and the sort of inadaptation. We never see his sensitivity, the sensitivity of the main character, until the final scene of the movie when he practically destroys his restaurant violently. The story is told from the subjective point of view of the main character, Victor Modino, played brilliantly by Prude Taylor-Vince. Victor and his mother, whom he really adores and he's very attached to, own a small restaurant. They dedicate their entire day in maintaining the business properly and fulfilling the needs of the clients, even if we are talking about serving a coffee or preparing a proper meal. One day, a beautiful young woman named Kelly, played by Liv Taylor, arrives at the restaurant. She is hired to become a waitress. From this moment, her mysterious looks dazzled Victor, who he is immediately attracted and also torn between his obsessive love to her and the reality that he is living in. She completely changes his life and also turns his world upside down. The movie functions on two separate levels. One level embodies the subconscious of the main character Victor, and here we can always see, due to the shots and the way the camera moves towards the character, we can see his obsessive relationship with Kelly, the one that he continually and gradually constructs in his mind. He wants to have a bond and very intimate attachment to her, and she becomes the object of his affection, and all of his affects are very, very much oriented to the goal of being with her. Another level is the level of reality, pure and simple as it is. And unfortunately, on this level, we can see that he is trying to struggle and battle his inner demons, his fear of rejection, and the fear that he will eventually lose his loving and protective mother. We can see, there is one scene in the movie that really, really got to me, because we can see that Victor tries to hide the sudden death of his mother, and eventually he decides to take Kelly into a short road trip and present the fact that his mother is no longer alive. Kelly is shocked and she tries to consolate him, but he tries to become more close to her, and the woman rejects him. And this is a very powerful scene when we can see that this love that grows inside him remains only in his mind, and that reality is never and almost nothing that we see is like it seems. In an interview with James Mangold that can be found in the book entitled My First Movie, edited by Steven Lowenstein, we have access to director's vision and the way he chose to write and construct the character of Victor, and also the way he chose to construct the bizarre, intimate, and also obsessive relationship of Victor with Kelly. I shall read an extract from this interview in order to see and have a much better look upon director's inside mind. So, he's alive, he's had things happen to him that he will never forget. For example, the scene with Liv and him at the airport. I can't speak for everyone, but for me the power of that scene is that nothing much is going on other than the hopes and dreams of a guy who loves this savagely beautiful and incredibly kind girl, and that they come close to something happening. What I think is a miracle, and I credit it to the actors, is that you actually believe it. So, commenting upon this part of the interview given by Mangold, I can say that the movie does something that I never saw in all history of cinema, at least not in independent cinema history from the 1990s, is this wonderful, suggestive, intimate relationship between two characters that actually never kiss, never have sex or anything. They are just imagining things, or at least Victor does. So you can see this on the whole movie, and I think Mangold directs it pretty well and does a tremendous job. And also, I think that finally, Heavy remains a movie that speaks to us about the fact that sudden encounter with sudden people remain only in our memory, but can forever change our lives, even if we never have the courage, or we never speak the truth about our feelings towards one person. Thank you for watching, and looking forward to see you next time for sharing together the cinematic experience of American independent cinema.